This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now.
What
the voice of the must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey, how the hell are you? This is the Openly Hostile Opinions. I'm Jay. This is Casey. And
it's everyone.
If you see in our little hot seat here, we have another special guest.
Would you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor?
That is Ashley, the neighbor.
Yeah, she is my neighbor.
I'm like the best neighbor you've ever had.
Yes, we did not kidnap her. She's here on her own free will. She is.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. She is our neighbor, and she's just going to sit in with us today and talk about some crazy shit. And she doesn't really drink beer.
But we're forcing her to at least taste it.
And there's no roofies in it. She's good.
I watched him pour it.
Yeah.
It was safe.
Yes. So, speaking of that, what Playgirl Silent Club, Jay? Beer of the week?
This is our, if I can find it.
Let's bring up the label here. It is Magic Hat Vamplifier. It is a red ale, and I just bought it for the label. I never thought you'd get to use that sound clip again.
I know. I'm so excited.
I thought you would only use it for the fucking Halloween show, but I guess.
Yeah, so did I.
Yeah. So it's, like I said, it's a happy red ale. Ashley does not drink beer, so she's probably going to hate this.
That's hoppy.
Yeah, yes. don't use my opinion whatsoever.
Yeah, we're not going to.
It's going to taste like shit.
Regardless. Actually, yeah, I don't know. I don't see a percentage or anything like that. Oh, 5.2. That's pretty normal for a red ale. So, yeah, let's go ahead and try this. Cheers, mate. Over there. Ding dong.
Oh, that's horrible.
You don't like that?
Oh, God.
I think it's delicious.
I know, it is really good.
Oh, God.
You don't like that at all?
No. Ew,
oh, my
no.
God, you barely took any.
Yeah, I'm aware.
I think it's fucking great.
It is really good. That is really good. I'm going to try that again.
Hell yeah.
Well, by all means, please try mine. Oh.
Oh, man. You got to finish it at least.
She most certainly does not.
When you do drink, you barely drink at all, but when you do drink, what do you drink?
I drink like mixed drinks.
Oh, really? What kind
of drinks? Girly frou-frou drinks?
Yeah, I don't really like the taste of alcohol. Unless I take shots. I can take shots.
Alien piss, your favorite shot?
That is the most disgusting thing you've ever made.
Alien piss?
Yeah, I made her a shot one time and she fucking freaked. She said it was horrible.
That was the most disgusting thing I've ever tasted.
What the hell is in that?
Piss, basically.
Dude, everyone else liked it and I made it for her and Chelsea and like no one fucking liked it.
I'm pretty sure he took it in the back, pissed in it, and then brought it back out and was like, hey, here's a shot.
This is Casey. It's quite possible.
Hey, man, I thought it was fine. Everyone else fucking liked it. Like
everyone else, there was like three of us in the bar. Two out of the three of us didn't like it.
Where we live, that's a full crowd.
Yeah, I know. Oh, actually, that reminds me. I wanted to talk about something today.
Oh, good Lord.
They are making a new Jumanji movie.
Why?
Because The Rock is in it. That's why.
Does The Rock's dad make shoes? Because... apparently, I didn't even know that was in the original movie.
Yeah, do you like The Rock, Ash? You think he's hot?
I used to.
What happened now? He's getting old?
Yeah, no, you can't say stuff like that about being old.
Oh, yeah, I forgot your boyfriend's like 20 years older than you. Sorry, Jason. Yeah, if you haven't figured this out yet, the Jason on our wall, the badasses, this is his girlfriend.
Yeah, Jason, we often refer to him as the surly satellite installer.
Yeah, we try to get them both on, but he works every fucking Tuesday. So
he works every fucking day.
Yeah, he works a lot. And getting back to the Jumanji thing, this is a picture of it. I don't know who that girl is, but I'd let her use me as a tampon.
I can't see it from here.
I don't give a fuck. Like, I don't know who she is, but she's
hot. I have
no
idea who she is.
Yeah, but she's hot. Jack Black's in it. Kevin Hart's in it. He's like, just, I don't know. It looks fucking awesome. I can't wait.
I'm sure it's going to be terrible.
Yeah, it's probably going to, but I don't fucking care. That girl played in Guardians of the Galaxy, I guess. I don't really know who.
Oh, that chick.
Yeah, I have no idea who it is.
This is the one who played Gamora.
No, that was a black chick, I think.
Yeah.
That girl wasn't black.
I couldn't see from here. What part of I can't see from here? Do you
there
not
was
understand?
A black person on there.
Okay.
It was Kevin Hart.
I'm blind.
I can't wait. Fucks. I can't wait. I love Kevin Hart. I think he's fucking hilarious, but whatever.
I like him because he's short.
Yeah, me too.
He's super short.
But, yeah.
Hey, he's the same height as me. Fuck you.
Just like Ben Roethlisberger's a lot taller than you, Jay.
Y'all can kiss my fat ass.
Oh, man, that was hilarious.
Oh, I'm glad I amuse you.
Wait, how tall are you?
I am 5'5".
5'5". I think I was 5'5 in, like, eighth grade.
Maybe that's seven. Ashley's busting jokes.
Hell, I like you. You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
Oh, Jesus, man. She's getting right into it. She's give a fuck.
Fucking ruthless.
So, yeah. After making Jay want to cry like a baby, we have our first thing here. Let's get a picture up here because this is amazing. So, quick thinking mom saves life by giving gunman a blowjob.
I love how they try to make it safe for work and not blocked out by the filters by putting a zero in
yeah, but
for job.
I got an AFK for saying I got something to do. Just joking. Yeah, I was like looking for her address and shit. I'm like, where's this bitch live? I got, you know, I need a new couch. I got to see where she lives. But yeah, there's a picture of her. It's not a big article because I don't know what else you can say about it. He was armed and dangerous, but so is my mouth. Oh my God, I didn't even read that part yet.
Fantastic.
Of course, she's from Texas. That makes sense. Jennifer Bale is a hero to her family. They're calling her a hero. Okay.
Hell yeah.
Four. Oh, there was four kids. Holy shit.
Was there four kids or is it a family of four?
Jennifer is a hero to her family of four. Okay. Well, she obviously doesn't have
a... Was her husband there? And she just allowed this to happen?
I don't know.
I would.
He was probably at work or something like that.
Jennifer's husband, Raymond, only had one thing to say about the ordeal. She's never given me head like that. We'll talk about that later.
Is this a real story?
Dude, that's... I don't know.
What website is this?
It's Fox News or Now 44 News.
I never heard of that. I'm thinking this is a... Think of this as a satire website.
I don't know, but that was the best thing
ever. I don't know, dude.
That was great.
I don't know.
She's never given me head like that, but we will talk about that later. Yeah, for now, I'm just glad our children are safe.
Yeah, that's all she's happy about, man. She's never given me head like that. Yeah.
I feel sorry for him.
Yeah, his name is Raymond.
Oh my God, did you read the thing above it?
No, what?
To say I'd do anything for my children would be an understatement at this point. Plus, he wasn't a Minuteman, so it was a lot of work.
Oh my God.
This has to be fake. There's no fucking way.
Dude, I don't know, man. I don't know. Like, to save your kids? Jay, to save your kids, would you put a dick in your mouth?
You would.
Who said it would be to save my kids?
Oh, touche, touche.
Don't talk about my fucking Tuesdays.
Oh, yeah. So I thought that was good. You know, whatever.
I mean, seriously, I would do that. I told you.
What?
I would totally do that to save my kid. Jesus.
We should bring your kid on here.
No.
We should not.
No, we should not.
She's, oh my God.
She has a very, I don't know what word to use it, enthusiastic kid.
Enthusiastic.
Yes.
She's a sarcastic brat.
Yeah.
She's
very, has high energy. She's always getting hurt. Like every time I talk to her, she's like, yeah, I fell off a couch or something and hurt my head. She should be wrapped in bubble wrap.
She's something.
Yeah.
She's mini me for sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just a lot in a 9-year-old.
Yeah.
Oh, well, and you got a pedophile up the road. You got to learn to run fast.
Let's talk about that.
Let's talk about that.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah. Ashley, so who's your mom seeing these days?
How that pedophile up the road.
if you don't want to talk about it, you don't have to. But
we can talk about it.
Explain to our viewers. What
yeah, you go ahead and tell us the story. Go ahead. We love for our audience to hear.
How far back of the story am I going?
Oh, as far as you'd like.
We'll wrap it up in like a 30-second thing. Ready?
Okay.
We'll pull this. Okay, so...
So it's going to be longer than that gunman lasted.
No, apparently that gunman lasted right, a long time. Yeah, he wasn't a Minuteman.
Yeah, what was it?
She
had to work.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means
too early. I can't tell us. All right, so tell us the story.
All right, so back in July, my parents, who were married for 33 years... my mom decided that she was leaving my dad out of nowhere on a Sunday afternoon, if you will.
You remember the day.
Of course I do.
I remember like yesterday.
Yeah.
That was creepy as fuck, Casey.
So,
I remember it like yesterday.
So my mom left, walked her stuff across the yard to the neighbor's house, who happens to be the said pedophile.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
It's not alleged.
Oh, yeah, he was convicted. All right.
Well,
yeah.
He said that she was sitting on his lap and his cell phone fell and he fell in her. That was the statement, and I am not joking.
What?
Oh, you didn't hear that?
You didn't hear that story? That part of the story?
That's what, so I, much. Yeah, that's what he told everyone, because I think that's what his lawyer said. Dude.
Moving on.
Well, that was quick.
If a porn star was sitting in my lap, my hand just wouldn't have fell in. Like, that is the most bogus story I've ever heard in my life.
All right, so she decides to do this. Does your mom? I have questions.
Yes.
Is your mom aware of the allegations? What was she aware of the allegations at the time?
Yeah.
Does your mom watch this show?
I hope not.
Okay, so she was aware of the allegations. So she left your father, who by all accounts is a pretty decent human being.
As far as I know.
As far as we know.
Jim, right?
Yeah.
Is that Jim?
Who's currently dating a stripper.
Yeah.
Good for you, Jim.
And Ashley is not happy about that. But the man's got to do what a man's got to do.
She's 23 years old. She's a crack whore.
I know, but you got to fuck the pain.
You know, you don't think he knows she's using him? Oh, he's well aware.
Yeah.
I assure you. Anyway, moving on. I have more questions. So she was aware of the allegations.
Yes.
Does she believe said allegations?
Yes.
Jay's like speechless. He's like,
so she thinks that it's a better option to go with a man who is accused of fucking a child.
Because she's happy now.
Happy now.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you know what's funny?
She knows he's going to prison, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I know this is off topic, but I completely forgot to rate the beer.
We'll get back to that.
I don't know what pedophiles, hearing about pedophiles made me want to rate a beer, but you know.
Okay, I'm rating it. It's four out of four unmarked pedophile vans.
Yeah, there we go. That's good enough.
Okay, now right. It's done. Moving on.
get your clipboard out, because I know you have one full of like questions for it.
No, I'm just I'm coming up with them as they come to me. So she knows he's going to prison.
Mm-hmm.
She plan on waiting for him?
As far as I know.
As far as I know.
She asked me what I thought she should do.
What did you tell her?
I told her that she was with my dad for 33 years and that she had me when she was 16 years old and that she's never been single in her life before, so that perhaps she should utilize that time while he's away to discover who she is and just have fun. And if she still loved him when he got out, that would be different.
So you told your mother to go fuck people. Basically fuck everyone.
Yeah.
Okay.
but you left the avenue open for her to return to the pedophile.
Well, yeah.
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 Okay.
I did.
Well, they usually do turn back to the pedophile because he always has free candy.
He did give me Scrapple yesterday.
Scrapple. Is that a euphemism for anything?
That's how you get women at Glenmar. You give them Scrapple.
I mean, it is head meat.
That's a way to a woman's heart here in Pennsylvania. It's just give
come her here, baby. Let me give you some meat.
Give you some Scrapple.
Who doesn't love Scrapple?
We were just talking about this last week. About how Pennsylvania's fucked up and how people out here drink or eat like Scrapple, like, and you're like, I don't want candy. I want Scrapple.
we can't
make this shit up.
Let's put that head meat in your mouth, baby.
Like, you just can't make this up. Oh, man. And I don't think you watched last week's episode, so I don't even think you knew we talked about Scrapple.
No, I had no idea. I didn't watch it.
So that's a way to a woman's heart out here. So anyone that's from Pennsylvania, just give them, give them Scrapple.
Please send the Scrapple to me, please.
Yo, I got that Scrapple, baby.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, you DTF? Got that Scrapple, dog.
Do you put maple syrup on your Scrapple?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah, that's what I like.
And mustard. Ketchup.
Mustard, oh, baby. Ketchup. Mustard.
Mm-hmm. Ugh.
Ugh. Mustard. My grandfather puts like that Cairo syrup. Cairo syrup.
What?
Cairo.
What's
syrup?
Cairo? Corn syrup.
What are you talking about? Corn syrup. Yeah.
It's vanilla flavored corn syrup. Is what
I've never heard of.
Super thick.
This is just a class act today. Oh, man.
It's super hot in here.
I know. It's the fucking coal stove,
that's
man.
The blushing.
It's the fucking coal stove, man. Oh, man. I turned it down to 60 degrees, and it fucking just gets
that's
warm.
The awkward silence.
It's just... I just can't do it anymore. This is
ridiculous. Really... I can't do it, man.
Oh, man.
Jason told me I was supposed to behave before I came on.
Fuck him.
Did he really?
There's no behaving.
He's like, can you please just behave?
Why would you behave? What's the point of being on the show?
I never behave. That's
why. Did he give you, like, guidelines?
No.
If we thought you were going to behave, we wouldn't have invited you on the show.
I know. We were all excited. Like, Ashley came into the bar I work at, and I was like, we got our microphone in finally from China that was back ordered, and they didn't tell me.
I think they swam it here on the back of Chun-Li's ass.
Yeah. No, the Cubans are the ones that come in on boats.
Chun-Li can come in wherever she wants.
Yeah. Oh, man, Street Fighter. Oh, I love that game. It's so amazing. All right, so moving right along. I thought this was interesting. So the person that for AOL that says you got mail.
Were you done asking questions?
I'm sure more will come to me as time goes by.
Okay.
So the person that did you got mail for AOL is an Uber driver.
You got mail. He's an Uber driver.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Everybody's an Uber driver.
Here is a picture of her or him. I can't tell what it is.
That's a him.
Of course it's a guy. He's just got long hair.
Dude, it looks like an old woman, doesn't it?
We grew up in the fucking 80s, man. People have long hair.
They're like my God, they're like those glasses for like blind people.
Yeah, I know. And that's why I was like, it sort of looks like he's just missing the bag over tear when it's raining out. Like, so apparently...
Let me inform you who doesn't wear glasses here that those are designed to fit over your glasses. There's a reason why people wear those.
You don't wear contacts? Do you wear contacts? You don't wear anything? Damn, you got good eyesight.
Fuck you.
Did you eat carrots a lot when you were younger?
No.
I did, and they didn't do shit.
I wore glasses from kindergarten to sixth grade.
How the fuck did you get out of it?
Fuck if I know. I went to the doctors one day and was like, I have really bad headaches. And they were like, oh, you should go to the eye doctor. So I went back to the eye doctor, and the eye doctor was just like, your eyes are good.
So well, you just stopped needing glasses?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Did you get bit by like a radioactive spider or something?
Yes.
She got bit by a radioactive carrot.
Yeah. By radioactive, scrapple loaf.
Good old scrapple.
I can't believe you said that.
You know what
that.
Else is really good?
What?
What are those things called that are like nothing but like pure fat?
Cracklins.
Yes.
Of course, the fat guy answers this question.
Jay, you are right on that, dude. You are right on that.
Those are the best things ever. I can feel it, like, feeling in my arteries when I eat it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm still, like, fucking coughing up shit from a while ago. So, you know, I've still been sick and everything like that. So, moving right along. Because, we got a couple more stories for you here, and then look at this guy's face. Oh, I love it.
Oh, my God. Yeah,
we're going to play a game later.
He looks like Daniel Stern in Home Alone.
He does. Let me show you a picture here of this guy.
Oh, he's a cutie.
That's me in the morning.
Oh.
Cops arrest man accused of terrorizing California city with air horn.
Was he just like running up and down the street?
I don't know, but I think he pointed the air horn at the wrong direction. Like, that's when I saw this picture. I was like, did he have it facing the right way?
Please tell me he ran up and down the street going, the British are coming! The British are coming!
Probably. I don't know. Air horn that sounds like a train has been terrorizing the residents for weeks, but police in California have arrested a man in connection with the noise. He had air horn equipment in his car, they say. The bus came early Sunday around the many of the alarming loud incidents would occur. The sound train coming through the neighborhood. The noise has been playing residents on the west side of the city for weeks. It took him weeks to catch this guy? Like, how can you miss him?
He just
him?
Didn't want to sit outside of somebody's house and wait for him to come by. Yeah, like, just... Do they use Williamsport cops there? Is that the problem?
Yeah, I know. They don't do shit. He has been doing this for weeks, and they've been chasing him for weeks, but we got him. Like, there's drug dealers and shit. They're going after guys with air horns. I used to do this when I was a kid. No one gave a shit. Like, they would just, like, crash and, you know, and then you just run or whatever like that. I've never done that.
I feel like he totally did that.
He probably did.
I just love that guy's picture. Like, that's probably my dad. Never mind. My dad's dead.
Dad took a depressing turn.
Yeah. Jesus. But that reminds me. A couple episodes back, we were talking about how a woman died in my house. And we're pretty sure the stain's still there.
Oh, it's there.
We've had it confirmed.
When Ashley came over, she's like, oh, that's where she died. That's like the first thing she said.
She's lived here her whole life.
But not here.
Not here.
But like
in this town.
Area. Town.
This is a town of like 10 houses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've lived in two of them.
Yeah, I think there's probably, what's Glenmar population? Probably like
50?
50. Probably. Yeah, it's not.
And I mean, my family's like 30 of them.
Yeah, so. I know. It's all the same family out here. Like, when I moved out here, they called me the renter. Because I wasn't family or anybody they knew. So they called me the renter.
Ding, 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 ding.
And I pretty much got along with everyone. Everyone's great out here. Makes me look sane, but whatever.
It would take a lot more than that to make you look sane.
Yeah. But, Where'd you live at before here? Did you move out here when you got married?
What?
Did you move out here when you got married?
No, in the house I live now is the house I grew up in.
Oh, okay.
She's literally lived here her whole life.
I've literally lived here my whole life.
I mean, if you include our entire township, which encompasses my town, their town, everything, it's less than 500 people.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah, because you got Hughesville.
Like the population, I looked it up.
What's after Hughesville? Pitcher Rocks? Then you got like Ty Volley.
Hey, why don't you draw him a fucking map to our studio
yeah,
there, Case?
Yeah, so all these guys can bring her Scrapple.
Hell yeah, write that shit down.
Oh, man.
Not responsible if anybody abducts our guest.
Most people want flowers and chocolate. She's like, give me fucking pig skull.
Let me get your meat.
If I get kidnapped at gunpoint, just remember.
Yeah.
Just take that pig head and boil that shit.
Yeah, just put that dick in your mouth. That's how it works. We should probably stop talking. Jason told us.
I'm in so much trouble.
I know, Jason. Jason told you to behave.
Fuck Jason. Jason won't come on our show because of work.
I know. Who fucking works?
Fucking won't call off once in a while to be on a show.
He is a workaholic.
Fuck him.
He is a workaholic.
Now watch next week. He'll be on here and kick my ass for saying all this because he's significantly.
I know he just wants to come on the show to call you a commie.
That's fine.
He always calls Jay a commie.
He always does.
Yeah,
always does.
Jason's very funny.
Jason's hilarious.
Yeah,
the best part about Jason is no matter what you're arguing about, he will argue on the opposite side of it for fun.
Oh, he told
It doesn't matter what it is.
Yeah, he's
and if you're the sober one watching it go down, it's hilarious.
It's great.
If you're the drunken one who he's doing it to,
it pisses you off.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's an extremely large instigator.
Yes. Yes, he is. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he is. That's a huge I know, because like sometimes he'll be drinking, and Jay will be like, "So you've crossed the threshold, I see."
Yeah, he gets to a certain point after a certain amount of alcohol, he becomes confrontational. We'll say
he just loves fucking with us. It's fucking hilarious. But before we move on to the game, we have one last thing.
Well, he is like a father figure. Oh.
Do you just make fun of him? Oh, my God, man.
You know, lately he's been wearing a little beanie hat. I keep saying he looks like Burgess Meredith in the Rocky movies.
Come on, Rock. You got to get it back. Yeah, he does.
You got to get back in the ring, Rock. Get up off your feet.
Yeah, he does. He looks like a dock worker.
He's a bum. He's a goddamn bum.
You're a bum, Rock.
Knock the bum out.
No, but he does.
Is he his pipe?
Huh?
His pipe?
Yeah, he bought.
Oh, yeah, he's been fucking smoking a pipe. I'm not talking weed either. He's smoking straight up, like I smell it wafting in the kitchen.
It does smell really good, though.
It does smell good.
It does. It's like this vanilla.
He looks so natural.
Dignified.
I know,
yeah.
Like, he's one of the only people I know whose beard can rival mine. Not this week. But.
Like, I told him to get anchor tattoos on his arms because when he wears this hat, he looks like a dock worker. Yeah,
I think we're gonna get matching tattoos.
Oh my God!
Actually. Oh, how fucking lovely and sweet! I can't say shit. Me and my wife.
Has this been a real conversation, or was this just an idea?
No, it's been a real conversation. Oh,
Jason, don't do it.
Shut up, Casey.
Or if
it's like peeing on him, but like permanent.
so you're marking him like a female cat does.
If you do it, get something that's indecipherable. Don't do a name.
That's not gonna happen.
Like Jay, you got something with your wife, didn't you?
Yeah, I have. It's either Norse or Icelandic. I can't. There's been debate.
Jay's
I got
dying.
Shit caught in the back of my throat.
Did someone break into your house recently? Or what's
like, kind of like that, Mom.
Jay, I'm coming over tonight.
It's either a Norse or Icelandic love symbol is what it is.
That's right. Okay.
We were looking at is it Celtic, Celtic?
Celtic.
You can pronounce it either way.
Yeah. Okay, so because
I'd say Celtic. Celtics are like the basketball team. I'd say
it's the same. It's the same thing. Later. I always said Celtic.
I thank you because I said Celtic, and then Jason said it was Celtic, and whatever.
It really doesn't matter. It's like people who pronounce Neanderthal Neanderthal. I refuse. Yeah. Fuck you. It's Neanderthal.
I don't give a fuck. Whatever.
They do. That's the way they call it.
Okay, but that's not right.
I agree.
I hate grammar Nazis, so say whatever the fuck you want. I don't care. Whatever.
Yeah, Casey may have mispronounced his shit on a daily basis.
Yeah, I couldn't. The one day, I still can't say it. Burgerly. I can't say the word burgerly.
Is that a word?
What do you? Burger. Like, when you rob someone.
Oh, burglary.
Yeah, I cannot say that fucking word for some reason.
I used to date a chick who could not say.
I was trying to say, like, burger. Like, yeah. Burgerly.
No, I used to date a chick who could not say indubitably.
Indubitably.
Indubitably. We could break it down for her. Indubitably. But to put them all together was impossible for
her. All right, you ready? Because there's one word I can't ever pronounce, and Jason makes fun of me for it all the time.
Go ahead.
Similar.
Similar?
Similar. You throw that M in there. Mm-hmm. Similar.
Similar.
Mm-hmm. The M-U, everybody threw it.
I don't know if I've ever paid attention to how I pronounce that.
I never did either, Jason.
Oh, of course, because it's Jason.
It's similar.
You're a bum. God damn it, Rock.
You know what one...
I say it that way. Similar.
Similar.
It's similar.
Actually, I don't even
say that. You know what one that annoys the hell out of me?
What's that?
People who say library.
I know.
Library.
Yeah,
there's an R in there.
A lot of people that pisses off or something. And spaghetti. I think a lot of people say that. Sorry.
4-year-olds say paschetti, but those are 4-year-olds.
Yeah.
If you're above the age of 4, you no longer can get away with that.
Yeah. I know a lot of people that, for some reason, that pisses them off when they say library instead of library.
Oh, that one drives me nuts.
Oh, man, this beer's gassy, man.
Are they like, do they forget that there's extra letters in there?
I don't fucking know. There's a lot of grammar. I hate grammar Nazis. I can't fucking stand them.
I don't mind most mispronunciations, but library just gets me for some reason.
Library.
I don't care because I'm just happy someone talks to me.
We haven't figured out why yet.
Yeah, I don't know either.
It doesn't last very long.
I know. That's like when
I've known him since high school.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah. I gotta go.
I'm surprised anyone listens to me at all. Like, I just
I've known Casey since high school. I don't know. Maybe I have a bigger filter for bullshit.
Yeah, I don't know.
I've known you since when did you move in here?
June? Maybe. Yeah.
End of May.
Yeah.
Somewhere around there.
Yeah, and if you and Jason get married, you'll be the... Wait, let me see. 1, 2...
He had to get out.
No pressure.
The fourth couple that I've hooked up that gets married.
No pressure.
Jason.
I'm Jason.
I ain't never getting no married again.
Yeah. Get those extra hours at the docks, Jason. Get that ring.
Go for the prize fight, Rock. You're a bum.
I wish we had a picture.
I have a picture.
Do you have a picture of him with his little hat on?
No.
Damn it. Sneak us one and send it to us before Thursday.
Actually,
we'll
I
make
could
Casey
get on Facebook, but I think Jason would kill me.
you need to. Get it in there.
I don't know. There's personal information on there. So
No. Get the picture and edit it in later.
It off his Facebook page. We got this.
All right. I'll edit it in later.
We got this.
Do you have a picture with him with his hat on?
On his Facebook?
Yeah, you just need to send us the picture
and
edit it in later.
Send it to me after the show and I'll put it up.
Like that?
Yep, perfect. That's exactly what you need to send.
Yeah, he looks like a dock worker.
He's going to kill me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, but it's so worth it.
He's going to kill all of us.
I love you. I promise I'm going to marry you someday.
He's going to come in with like an anchor on a chain over his shoulder and like flail around like a mace and like knock us down with it like they did in Braveheart.
As long as he eats his spinach, he'll be fine.
Like in Braveheart where he broke into that guy's house with a mace, just fucking beat his face in. Oh, I love that movie.
Great. Except for the whole movie is about the storming of that bridge, and the bridge wasn't in the fucking movie.
Yeah, I know. That's because he was too busy yelling freedom.
You focus on the wrong part.
Yeah. Oh, God forbid the there'd be a little historical
was on the freedom, okay?
Yeah, he just needed freedom.
I forget the name of the fucking bridge, but I mean, literally, that was called the Battle of the Something or Other Bridge. They left a bridge out of the fucking movie.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. But I still love that movie. The best part is where he finds out they kill his wife, and he comes in with those antlers, and his hand just fucking guts that guy right in the throat. Oh, best fucking thing ever. I love it.
Mel Gibson will forever be Max Ratatowski.
I know. Hansky, Mel Gibson's whatever. Not a bad guy when he's not Mad eating Max. Jews.
Yeah.
But when he's hating Jews, it's like, oh, okay, Mel, take your meds.
Well, didn't he like beat his wife?
I have no idea. Was he like Chris Brown in her? Or what was going on?
Probably.
Wasn't there that big scandal for a while?
I have no idea.
She had it like recorded of him like completely flipping out.
I don't know.
Right when the Passion the of the Christ thing. Movie came out, remember?
I do there remember that. Because that's how he got caught, because he was yelling about Jews on it or something.
Yes.
I think. Yeah, he called his wife.
I didn't know he beat his wife.
He wasn't beating her. But
I don't really know if he beat her.
That now. No, because he left the thing on her answer machine, like screaming at her. He was like bitching about Jews and shit.
Those goddamn Jews. Motherfuckers. Yeah, well, you know what? He will forever be endeared in my heart because he's fucking Mad Max. So.
Yeah, I know.
Yo, I found out they're making two more of those with Tom Hardy, which makes my dick rock hard.
Oh, I love Tom Hardy.
Tom Hardy makes my
dick rock hard. Your clitoral erectile tissue?
Ashley has a dick now.
Well, now we learned something about Jason.
We didn't know you swang that way, Jason.
And it sounds like she's the one doing the swinging.
I'm worth it.
I'm worth it. Oh, my God. I'm worth it.
Oh, moving along. What's your last story?
I think I found my girlfriend.
Oh, God. Your right hand? Yeah. She's been attached to you for a long time.
It's Jill. J-I-L-L.
That's pretty good.
Okay, so basically, this girl's from Penn State. That's right around where we live. Well, it's about an hour and a half.
Yeah, it's another goddamn copy.
There's pedophiles there.
Yeah, I know, exactly. That's, you know, that's where you go in as a tight end, come out as a wide receiver. But anyway, so I guess this girl's a fucking squirrel whisperer.
A squirrel whisperer?
Just wait, dude. Just wait. I'm probably going to get flagged for this shit because we can't even show a video on YouTube ever. So I'm actually, hold on.
Even for the purposes of parody, which should fall under fair use.
Actually, I won't play it at all. I'll just see if I get a picture of her. Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. That's better.
And she dresses these fucking squirrels up in like uniforms and shit. And she talks to them. And they ask her, like the one part they're asking her, like, why do you like squirrels? And she's just like, squirrels are great. Like,
that's you all. Can't play that video.
We'll probably get flagged for it.
Yeah, we have copyright problems. Tiny even though
it's oh my god, see we'll right there. We'll probably get. See, she makes
whatever. Just play the fucking video. Okay. I'll contest it if we get flagged.
Okay.
It's the squirrel whisperer, or even squirrel girl, which squirrel suits girl. Mary Krupa just fine.
Because everybody loves squirrels.
Oh my god! Look at her.
It's my girlfriend.
Look at her fucking teeth. She looks like a squirrel.
Oh my god, that's so cute.
It's nice to make something and see the.
Oh my god.
But I didn't
Dick
think
Skinner's on that one.
Someone break into her house, quick.
Come here, buddy.
Krupa's been interacting with the wild gray squirrel since her first week on campus.
I mean, we all know now why she's single.
At the time, Penn State was reeling from
my
the Jerry Sandusky sexual abuse scandal.
Why did they bring that up?
They have to bring it up.
Squirrels and they screwed up that? Are you serious?
Just because this bitch is cracking acorns open with her mouth.
From now, Penn State is still going to be the Jerry Sandusky issue.
I just heard, what do they say, actually? Hold on.
Campus. At the time, Penn State was reeling from the Jerry Sandusky sexual abuse scandal.
There was no need to bring that
really
in.
Down in the dumps, and I figured that Penn State needed something good to, you know, take their mind off things.
We just went to the Rose Bowl. We're good.
So
we didn't
I started
need squirrels.
Posting these pictures on Facebook, and Sneezy kind of became a little
Sneezy. She
mascot.
Named it Sneezy.
Sneezy the
Look
Penn
at her.
State squirrel was an overnight sensation.
The only time that bitch ever gets nuts in her mouth is when she cracked acorns with the squirrels.
She probably feeds them like birds. Cart. She's like,
Sneezy holding a jack-o'-lantern.
See, look at this shit, man.
Sneezy drinking tea and rooting for the home team. As Sneezy's fame
All right, turn that shit off. We're going to get copyright flagged.
I honestly knew who she was before.
No, you didn't.
No, you didn't.
No, you did not.
You were getting bitch.
Yeah, maybe. She was like that crazy bitch out in the quad.
If you knew her beforehand, you wouldn't go on the fucking TV. Be like, oh my God, I never knew her.
She was getting banged in some frat or something like that. That bitch didn't know what was going on. I like it how she did this, or she says she's doing it because people need to be happy. Because it's the Sandusky thing. Just whatever. And hey, now, I got to give it to her, man.
You go right ahead. No one else is giving it to her.
That's what I'm saying. I think I found my girlfriend, dude. Like, she's a little crazy, but whatever.
Lifelong.
Yeah, whatever. I whatever. No, I'm going to die.
All right. And now it's time for our favorite game show. Will you press the button? Dude, you need to, like, add an echo to my
face. Yeah, I will. Yeah.
I'll
put, like, stars coming in and shit like that.
We are playing...
Oh, this stuff's horrible.
Have you played this before?
Yeah, I get this stuff all the time.
We are playing Press the Button. It's, you know, you're familiar with our Would You Rather show. Mm-hmm. You've done that a couple of times. This is similar to that, but for those of you that don't know what it is, it's a website you can go to where you are met with a dilemma. Like, for example, I've seen one that's you get to have a functional lightsaber, but a child in Africa starves to death.
Just take the whole village out.
Whatever. Yeah.
Whole village.
So the question is, will you press the button to make that scenario happen, or no, you won't? And what we're going to do is we're going to look at the scenarios, we're going to discuss them, we're going to decide whether or not to press the button, and if we're wrong, we get to spin the wheel of death here and take one of these awful, awful beans, and I hope to God... Oh my God,
I don't have enough coffee. I can tell you that.
This is going to be a bad day.
See, that's why you get... You know, nuclear mug.
I'm just
going to
drink out of his coffee.
I hope we don't lose. How much time do we have left in the show?
I don't know. I didn't know when we started. What time did we start?
I don't know. Pull up the recording software and find out. This could be bad.
We are only 37 minutes in.
Oh, this is going to be ugly.
So we got to play for a while.
All right.
I just hope I don't get that sour milk. I hate that shit.
Oh, that was the worst
one. I feel like
this
is going to be the moment when everybody finds out how heartless I am.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
That's kind of the point.
Well, you suck dick for Scrapple, so I think we already...
No, wait a second.
Yeah, actually, that wasn't it at all. I got my stories confused. We've talked a lot about a lot of things in the last half hour.
I would suck dick to save my kid.
Ah, that's right.
I will accept Scrapple from pedophiles. That's right.
I don't really think either of those are much better than the other.
I feel like me and Jay have to be the only people right now that know a girl that got Scrapple from a pedophile. Like,
do you know many other girls whose 54-year-old fathers dating a 23-year-old stripper?
No, yeah. No, don't know.
I'm proud of them.
I know, I am too.
I know, the first day your whole complaint about the whole thing was, well, she's using him. You don't think he knows that?
I know, dude.
Oh, he's man. Well yeah. aware.
He's using that shit. She's okay looking. I think she looks very white trash.
She's very white trash.
Yeah, she's just like fucking...
What's the downside?
I don't know. Here's the weird part. Okay, I seen a picture of her. She has a couple kids, and it's really weird that she strips, and she has her kids' footprints tattooed on her stomach. I find that a little weird.
Really? Because you see the tattoos or not her tits?
I don't know. She doesn't have big tits, I don't remember. They're like little jelly beans, it looked like.
I mean, they were huge.
Dude, ask your dad. We want her on the show.
No.
I know. That's my goal.
She can even Skype in. We don't need the stripper germs on the chair.
My goal is to get a porn star on here. If that happens, I will die happy.
Yeah, we got it. Like I said, we can Skype him in. I don't want to get the germs on the chair.
No, I don't care. I like them dirty. Whatever. You know.
That's my chair.
I just think that's weird that she has her kids... footprints tattooed on her stomach, probably because that's where, you know, every guy's landing target is, you know.
Oh my God.
So he's like coming on these kids' like legacy. I just don't. Wow. No, that's weird.
Legacy.
Yeah. See what I did there? No, actually, I didn't do that. That was good though, Jay. I didn't realize I did that.
All right. So here's our first question.
Oh, not this again.
Lady and gentleman.
Lady. I'm not a gentleman.
No. I was calling her the gentleman.
That's right. She has a penis. Remember?
Correct. Okay, here we go. You lead the human race into a new golden era, ending world hunger, stopping all human conflict, and bringing forth free energy. You are remembered forever as the hero of the human race, but all your friends, loved ones, and children will die a painful, slow death 1 year after meeting you, and you can no longer enjoy your hobbies. Will you press the button?
Fuck off.
Yeah.
I will not.
No.
We are in agreement. 62% of people did not press the button.
Wait, I thought I said press the button.
You said press the button?
I forget what I said.
He did not say that. I don't know. Wait, does he have to eat one regardless?
No.
Like, wait, is this an all or nothing thing?
No.
What was the question again?
You lead the human race into
So basically, you
save all of humanity, but everybody you know and love dies.
Everybody you know and love dies within a year of meeting them.
I don't love anyone.
So, well, fuck you, Casey.
So, I'd just do everything for the
world. All right, spin the fucking thing.
Wait, so everyone else picked their families?
Yes.
Yes.
What the fuck is wrong with people?
We have kids.
Yeah, that's right. Ah, dead fish. That's the one you still taste
strawberry
in the morning.
Strawberry banana smoothie or dead fish?
I can't tell, man.
It's the pink.
They're all pink.
Is it pinky? Or is it like...
And the brain. The Abby pinky and the brain. Where is it?
I think it's this one, right?
Is it the dark? I can't fucking tell. I went to school for art. I can't tell.
I think you know what? I think it's the solid, not the clear.
The solid one?
I think the solid pink.
That one? Or is that dog food?
No.
I think that's the right one.
Oh, God.
I pray for dead fish.
Nope. Woohoo! Smoothie.
Lucky you.
Oh, thank God.
All right. Next one. Oh, this, lame. I'm not going to do some of these.
Was it suck dick or get scrapped?
No, it's like, well, you'll meet your true love, but you'll get friend zoned for 3 years. Who gives a fuck?
Yeah, if you get friend zoned, you just rape them.
You just have sex with them.
That's what I said. I said that one time. They're like, it sucks when a guy gets friend zoned. I'm like, just go have sex with someone else.
What the hell?
Yeah. Who cares?
All right, here's one. Unlimited gasoline, but you can only drive that one car for the rest of your life.
Ooh.
I will not. Because that car is going to break, and then that gasoline is going to be fucking worthless unless you're taking baths.
Yeah. Wait, where does the press the button thing come in at?
If you press the button, you get unlimited gasoline, but you have to keep the same car for the rest of your life.
I'm going to say no.
Yeah, I'm with no.
Yeah, no.
All right.
Yeah, the car is going to break down.
Oh, my God. We are wrong.
What?
You fucking Jew motherfuckers out there.
What is wrong with you people? When the car breaks, you're fucked.
People don't think like that.
Oh, no. Coconut.
Is it the sour milk?
It's the fucking coconut or spoiled milk.
Oh, this is the worst one, man.
All right, everybody grab a white one.
Why can't there be a scrapple flavor?
Why can't there?
I know. How fucking about it?
All right.
This one lingers.
Oh, I hate this one.
Let's go. Of course I can.
Oh, fuck.
You get coconut?
Yep.
You fucking bitch. You fucking bitch. Oh, this one is so bad.
This is pretty good.
Oh, my God. Why?
Kind of tastes like an Almond Joy, but without the chocolate.
I have never gotten the fucking coconut. I always get...
Here, buddy. I have a little bit left. Or have hers. Oh, actually, yeah. I'm going to have hers.
God. What's wrong with you people? When your car dies, you're fucked.
I know. I hate
Maybe
that
it's
one.
Based on the fact that the car never dies.
Didn't say that.
It's not a Transformer. It's not Bumblebee. Ugh. Oh, my God. Why does it linger, man? It's like a fart.
All right.
Mine tastes pretty okay.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
Good for you.
Good for you.
Your favorite band creates a new album which has your new favorite songs of all time, but they never record another song or go on tour ever again. I'm pressing the button. Because you know what? I listen to mostly older recorded music anymore.
Yeah.
Today's music's garbage.
Yeah, I don't have a favorite band, so sure, have at it.
What?
All right, so we're pressing it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Narrow margin. We won, but it was narrow margin, 51-49%.
If I had to guess, I'd say my favorite is Yellow Wolf, but that would be the
who?
Yellow Wolf.
I've never heard of him.
What?
Yeah. Have you, Jay?
No.
Really?
That's a new one on me.
Really?
Yellow.
Jason loves them. That's the only reason.
What kind of music
I know
is it?
Them. It's like a southern rap.
No, that's why I don't
Yellow
know.
Wolf. I'll check Yellow. Out.
Southern rap, you
Yellow.
Say?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I don't know.
Like back in the day when they like you made fun of someone, you're like, you yellow boy.
Yeah, like that.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't do the whole rap thing. Not to mention Jason and I disagree on music quite a bit.
Oh yeah. That's where the stories between
I
him and Jason
you
get into.
You have that Misfits connection.
We do.
Do you like that badass shirt I bought him?
I do, it's awesome. You bought that for him?
I did.
I'm impressed. I want one just like it.
I think it was either Spencer's or That other gothic store. That I won't really
hot topic.
Yeah, thank you.
I won't go into either of those stores.
You were so disgusted. You're like, that other gothic store.
I won't go into either of those.
You were so disgusted.
Do I look like I'm one of those people? I'm a Gap.
I don't think they look like they belong on.
You were so disgusted. That was great. All right, moving right along.
I bought them online, so I didn't have to actually go into the store.
You didn't want to be seen in there.
I wouldn't want to be seen in there.
That's true.
Here's one.
Oh, man, that's funny shit.
Okay, you're invisible, but you are always invisible. And if they try to paint you, you'll also be invisible. You can never, ever be seen, not even by yourself. Fuck yeah.
Or what?
Can you talk still?
You're invisible, but you can never be non-invisible.
Fuck yeah, man. You know how many naked girls I could see?
Yeah, exactly.
Wait. You'd I'm going to say no.
All right. Well, I'm pressing the button. You pressing the button?
Fuck yeah.
All right, we're pressing the button. Well, you and I have to eat.
Why? Why wouldn't you want to be invisible?
I don't know.
I don't want people looking at me anyways.
Spin the fucking thing and see what our fate is.
The rotten egg or buttered popcorn.
Which one's that? Is that the...
This one, I think.
Oh, yeah, the yellow one with the little flecks.
Nah.
Why don't they have that? You know what they should have? Them separated out like the
they
candies.
They should put
like
fucking numbers on them.
Yeah.
Is this it?
Yeah. No, no. It's the lighter one. That's like the peach or whatever the fuck.
Is it this like yellow one?
Yeah.
It kind of looks like, yeah.
That's the egg.
Man, what do they put any good ones in here?
I don't think they do.
Yes, they do.
Oh my, yay! You don't want to got one. Those gothic jelly beans.
Gothic jelly beans.
Oh man.
Oh no, wait. That might be the buttered popcorn. That's right. We all collectively agreed that the buttered popcorn is just as bad as the rotten.
Yeah, egg. I'm pretty sure it's rotten egg. But what makes it worse is it's since it's sticky, it's pulling the rotten milk stuff that's stuck in my teeth out again. So I'm tasting it again. it's like double dipping a chip or
it's
something.
Like bad breakfast.
Yeah.
Why do we play this game?
Because we fucking hate ourselves.
Did you just refer to me as a bag lady and eats cat food?
You're not supposed to read those.
How can you see? Oh, that's right. You have good eyes.
I have good eyes.
I was going to say, that's like really tiny on there.
Here's a good one. You become the president of the United States, but everyone hates you. Just ask Trump.
Doesn't everybody always hate the president? Anyway?
Yes.
Yeah,
so I'm
going
to say yes.
Thanks, Obama.
I know.
I'm going to go with you.
Yeah, I'm pressing the button.
Yeah. Whatever.
We're wrong.
What?
Everyone hates the president no matter what you do anyway. So
what is wrong with you, dumb fucks?
Why would you not want to be president?
All right, Ashley, why don't you spin the spinner? Spin the good spinner. This one sucks.
Lime or grass clipping?
Lime or lawn clipping?
I actually don't mind this one. It's like going out. It's
this one?
Yeah, it's just the plain green one.
This one's like going out when someone just mowed the lawn.
Oh, wait. I ate
food. What? You're like free food.
Ooh, I got a good one. Finally. It's lime.
You see, I got grass clippings. I don't care.
I don't know which one it is.
If it's lime, it's strong.
Then it's clippings.
Yeah. See, it's not bad, is it?
No.
No.
Oh, mm-hmm. I finally...
You know why? Because everyone out here mows their fucking lawn every day.
We have to remove the audio of the lawn mowing constantly during the summertime.
That's what everyone does out here is they mow the lawn like every 5 minutes.
Everybody's even... old out here.
Yeah, I know. Like I say, they have like a lawnmower mafia out here. You're going to mow the lawn today.
This the day of my yard keeper's wedding.
Listen, when Mel would mow the lawn...
Mm-hmm.
My grandfather would get super pissed that Mel mowed the lawn, so he would mow the lawn the very
next
day. Yeah,
that's what they do out here. They have competitions. Like, their neighbor will mow, and they're like, fuck, I gotta mow the lawn.
Yep.
It can't be shorter than mine.
Yep.
Moving right along.
Some of these are fucking lame. Hang on, let me find a decent one.
God, man. I'm still tasting that milk. Did you get a bad one yet?
I got lawn clippings.
That wasn't that bad, though.
I only had two.
All right, this is an interesting one. We could have some existential debates on this.
Okay.
Everyone will like you, but nobody will love you.
No.
I don't give a fuck.
No.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go no.
I don't care if anyone likes me or loves me.
So are you going yes or no?
That's not true.
What do you mean that's not true?
You care.
No, I don't.
You do.
No, I don't.
He does.
I sit and play World of Warcraft all day. Why
but
do
you
I
like the people you play
but
with
you
to like
you,
don't
you?
You
play with, yeah.
I guess.
Okay.
But I don't think they like me.
That's because you're paranoid.
Yeah, that's because you have issues now. Okay, are you pressing the button or no?
Wait, I okay.
If well, you read press it again. If read you press the button,
read it again.
Everyone will like you, but nobody will. No one will love you.
Yeah, I just want people to like me. I don't care if they love me.
Right. What?
Yeah, I don't give a fuck about love. Love doesn't exist.
Bullshit.
You're spinning, motherfucker.
I would never people. Listen. People. I would never in a million years. I'm gonna make up for all the making fun of Jason right here. Right here. I would never in a million years ever give up the way that man loves me. Ever. Oh my God. Everybody else in the world could hate me and I would still never.
It's amazing what insanity you'll do for a relationship.
I need to be a fucking like hitch. Like how do I do
like
it?
The movie.
Like how do I do it?
I mean, you do it.
I hooked up four people and they all got married.
Like, were we all whores beforehand?
I don't know.
But
well, one of the marriages was my mother, so I don't know what she did in her spare time.
She has sex.
I know.
I don't know, but you're trying to get out of eating the fucking thing. Spin your thing.
See, and that's what pisses me off. Everyone's so obsessed with being in love. Like, they didn't even think that question over. Bullshit.
That's because not all of us are a bunch of miserable fucks.
Look, my whole life was destroyed by love a couple years ago,
yeah.
And I still would
don't,
take it.
Yeah, don't get me started on that shit.
What's your poison here?
Fucking stinky socks or Tutti Frutti.
Ooh, the stinky socks are horrible.
Yeah, they're fucking
not bad. As bad as that spoiled milk.
Ugh, man. This reminds me of, what's that movie? Devil's Rejects. Tutti fucking Frutti.
That's a great movie.
Yeah, a good movie.
I think Abby saw that.
Right, it's Tutti Frutti.
You're a lovely parent.
Sometimes. Sometimes. Some people are meant to be. Some people aren't. I clearly wasn't. And
you're like, you already judged yourself. You're like, I clearly wasn't at all.
I just thought of another question.
What's that?
Do you allow your daughter to go over to hang out with grandma when she's with...
okay.
With the kid. There is an explanation with...
Yeah, there is.
Hold the phone.
We will. I'm gonna. Okay. So, at first, no.
At first, no. So that means that yes.
Yes, I do let her go over now, for two reasons. One, I'm not punishing anybody other than my daughter, who has spent every day with her grandmother since she was born.
I can't argue with that. Damn, Ashley.
I think grandma can come over to your house,
but grandma's not allowed over on the property.
Why?
My grandparents said no. My grandparents own the whole property.
Oh.
Like, they own all this shit.
Oh, I almost said your last name. Sorry.
My grandparents own all of it. So, like, my grandparents own the house next door, the house beside that, their house, and my house, and almost this house. So, my grandparents were like, yeah, no, she's not coming over.
See, that's why I can't be a parent. I wouldn't think that
far. But in saying that, there are rules when she is over there.
Those rules being?
She's
no cell phones. Sorry, I had to say it.
She is not allowed to be left alone. My mother has to be with her at all times.
Okay.
And, she was there last night.
Like, overnight?
Mm-hmm.
You're more trusting than I am.
No, you do make a good point, though.
Listen,
like,
I'm going to tell you, I mean, honestly, my mom is definitely making probably one of the poorest, most shittiest decisions of her life right now.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
I truly do not think that she understands or is going to truly feel what is really happening to her until much later from now. And she's going to regret the decisions that she makes, but that's her life and she's got to make them. However... I do not think that my mother would ever put my child in harm.
Yeah, I don't know. I still, you're more trusting than I am. I'd be like, nope, not, no, well, grandma, not getting to see the kid until.
But no, I can see your point. I don't have kids, but I can see your point.
I can see the point.
Do you really take your kid away from your grandmother?
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, I would in a heartbeat. Sorry, grandma.
I'd be like, grandma got ran over by a reindeer.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Your poor life decisions are not going to like send my kid to therapy.
And you know, it's really weird too, because you know, I've known Mel my entire life. His son was my best friend.
We probably shouldn't use names.
Whatever. Mel, you're a child molester.
Mel, you're a child molester. Yeah. So, I have...
Here's a kid.
One for you?
You get a kid. Everybody gets a kid. Yeah, Halloween's weird around here.
Anyway,
it's kind of like when the Avon lady shows
up. Yeah.
A whole different kind of trick or treat.
Oh, we just went to a dark place.
Oh, we're already there, Jay.
Yeah.
Why didn't we set up the studio at my house?
<I know. laughs> Oh, man, whatever.
Wait, did you eat your thing?
Yeah.
All right.
I got Tootie.
Are we on the next question?
Yeah. We're changing the subject, we are, apparently. Okay. Okay. You can go to any fantasy world you desire and live there, but you can be killed, and your survival in that world depends on your own physical or mental strength.
I'm fucked. No.
Yep. Yeah. Azeroth. Yeah. Send me to Azeroth. Take me with you. What is it?
I would... Nah, yeah, you know what I would? I'd be going to the Harry Potter world just so I can learn some tricks. some sick tricks.
Like the cereal tricks or some actual...
Some sick tricks.
Oh, okay. What?
Wingardium Leviosa! I'm pressing the button.
I'm saying no.
You don't have any fantasy worlds, do you?
No.
Ashley, you're spinning. Casey and I won this one around.
Hope you get soured milk, bitch.
I got stinky socks.
Or Tutti Frutti.
It has the blue shit in it. It's like pink with like bluest stuff.
Wait, which one is it?
It's that one right there.
One. This one.
Yeah. Sorry, like touch your food.
Oh, what's it going to be worse? Oh, I think she got the socks.
It's about time, bitch.
Oh, it's so bad.
Yeah. That one just tastes like fucking cotton.
Oh, I can't even swallow.
We know that answer now. Sorry, Jason.
Oh,
man. I'm gonna keep playing that till you get fucking puked.
Please don't. It's my house, my
When we do this, we should really bring a trash can in here for emergencies.
Oh, man. It's great. It's about time you lost.
That beer was still worse than it.
What? God, you really don't like beer. Jesus.
Not at all.
All right, what's that shit?
This is political. We're not doing that.
Yeah, please, no. Please, no.
What the hell is with the invisibility? Hang on.
I don't know. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Here's a good one. Some of these people who come up with these questions do not understand the concept of an existential crisis.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Anyway, so you get to travel first in an Earth-like planet and find a civilization where they crown you their king, but you can never go back to Earth.
Can I bring people back with me?
It doesn't say.
So we're going to say yes.
You could bring people to find the civilization with you, too, I assume.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. I'm sure. Down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck Earth.
Yep.
Yeah, fuck Earth. Just give us another planet.
Okay, we're in the clear. Okay, 67 to 33.
Okay. Is there a lot of repeats?
No, just a lot of them are stupid.
No.
No, here's one that just tells you whether you're conservative or a liberal. All the poorer than average people gain money, but all the richer than average people lose an equal amount of money.
Fucking press the button. That's my whole ideological thing. So wait, basically everyone is the same wealth.
That's it.
That's pretty much what they're saying. What
forever.
Well, no, it's like if every poor person got $1,000, every rich dude would lose $1,000.
Fuck yeah.
Press the fucking button.
$1,000 for a rich person?
Wait, they found that on their couch.
Wait,
this depends. This completely depends
on what?
Where do I fall? The poor person or the rich person?
Ashley, you live in Glenmar. You fall in the poor part.
Well, then, fuck
yeah. 77%.
Yeah. A rich person, yeah.
The 33% are the rich people.
Yeah, or 23%.
It's the 1%.
Math is hard.
Oh, man. That's great.
You okay? You gonna make it.
Math's difficult.
Oh, man.
All right. All the people of every nation, race, and belief will unite and create a near harmony. No conflicts between nations, but misery will still be there, such as diseases, pollution, etc. But internet will be removed forever. Fuck no!
No! Need my internet. Azeroth needs me.
We were right, but not by a very large margin. It was 47 to 53.
You fucking hippies.
Who? What? Why would you not? Who?
I don't know.
Honestly.
Amish people? No. I don't know.
You know why? It's little shits that have no idea what it's like to be without the internet.
I know. I think it's kids.
Mm-hmm.
They were like, what? There was a time with no internet? Yeah. I wonder what that was like.
It's like that bitch was like, how do old phones have the hashtag on them?
That's what it was. Yeah.
crazy people.
No, I'm trying to find a decent one here. Hang on.
Is this an app or are you on a website?
Well, it's an app for a website.
Yeah. An app for a website.
It's willyoupressthebutton.com, but it's their app. It's easier for me to do it on my phone than my laptop, so.
It's the same size.
Yeah, I do have a big phone.
That's a huge bitch.
You become a famous singer, but your fan base is completely made of 7 to 13 year olds. Just ask Justin Bieber.
I think that worked out for him.
You know what? We should ask Mel that question. I just snorted. 7 to 13 year olds. Wait, what? Why is it 7 to 13? Is there something really wrong with kids that age?
Well, no, that's just a demographic.
Yeah, it's a preteen. Like, you know, girls are like, just starting to act like Abby.
That'd be the teeny bopper, you know, like.
What's
like
so bad about it, though?
I don't know. I'd do it. I'd be rich and famous.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. I'm like, kids don't have money to buy your stuff, but the parents do. Yeah, I'd fucking do it.
Yeah, yeah. It was a no, wasn't it?
I can't believe it. It was a no. God, 48% to 52%.
I thought I hated kids. Holy shit.
I bet you this is all kids.
Nah. They're like, I hate myself.
All right. Spin the button. Spin the button.
Spin the button. Caramel corn or moldy cheese?
Which one's that?
I don't know. They all look alike.
Why do they look all the same?
I know. I don't get it.
We should all make them like fucking.
Maybe this one?
It's white with brownish flecks. Just say like these, I think.
No, I don't think. Isn't that what the other one looks like?
They should just number them. Like, why do I have to make them look all pretty and shit?
Yeah, I think it's these.
All right. Yeah. I'm going to guess.
Grab three of them out.
One. Oh, so help me God, if that one tastes good.
Two. Three jelly beans that taste like shit.
Maybe this one?
They should make an adult version.
I want like, that one.
tastes like a Tom Collins.
Yeah. A Tom Collins or a hooker's asshole.
Down the hatch, folks.
Oh.
That is fucking delicious.
That is cheese all day.
I got caramel corn.
Damn it. I gave that to you first.
Oh, my God. That is really good.
That is not moldy cheese. That is basement.
That is bad.
Dude, it smells like it tastes like mildew.
Oh, it did gag me.
Yeah.
Oh.
Sorry, Jason, again.
Well, damn, I don't know what you guys are bitching about. That was delightful.
Oh, man.
Wait, first of all, nothing about that tasted like cheese.
No, it tastes like musty.
It tastes
bullshit.
Like you go into an old basement.
It's like I ate mothballs.
I'm not going to ask how you know what mothballs taste like, but you know.
I assume that it's like that.
Well, Jason is old.
He can't even be here to defend himself. Fuck you, Jason. I'm just joking. I love
and for
you.
The record, he isn't 20 years older than me.
What is it?
13.
Oh, that's so much better.
That's not bad at all. Hell, when I talk to Jason, I think he's like my age all the time. I always forget his age.
People think that he's
I actually
like,
carded him when he told me what his age was.
Yeah, he does not look his age.
No, he looks like he's like 38.
Yeah, we'll post a picture of him though.
And then people think that I look like 36, which is...
I look 36.
Not okay.
You're like, fuck it.
All right, then. Moving on.
You got so depressed there. You're like, son of a bitch. All right, let's go. Like, motherfuckers.
All right. Well, you press the button. You become fat, but everyone loves you and will give you $1,500 a day.
Fuck yeah.
Bring on the heart disease.
You can buy sex. Like, Jesus.
Can I buy surgery to get rid of the fatness?
Good point.
They didn't say you couldn't.
So, yes.
Pressing the button. Oh, yeah, 72 to 28. It wasn't
good
even a
point,
contest.
Ash. Good mm-hmm. point. That's a good point.
I'm
man.
A woman. We think about surgery to be looking better all the
You're
time.
You're like, money and weight loss? Like, that's me.
That's me.
This one's so simple, but yet so good. You get to live forever, but you still age.
No.
No. Who wants to live forever, man?
I mean, you deteriorate.
People always ask me.
But hey, before you jump to a conclusion, remember, if you live forever... They're going to come up with shit to damn near make you a cyborg. I mean, you'll be able to regain
your... I
don't know.
Who wants to live forever? I don't even want to live right now.
I don't know. I'm pressing the button. What are you guys doing?
No.
No. That sounds horrible. Spin that wheel,
there
you
are
bitch.
People that I do not like and wish to not spend any more time with than what I have to.
I know. Jesus Christ.
I don't know. I have faith in science.
I know. Everyone would die around you that you love and you have to fall in love all over
God
again.
God damn motherfucking coconut or rotten milk.
Yeah.
Eat that milk, bitch. You take that milk.
I feel like I'm directing a porno.
Please let it be coconut. I have not gotten the coconut yet.
That is the worst, too. That's my worst.
I'm preparing. I'm taking this like a shot if it's the wrong time.
It's like a chaser.
Can't tell, can you? The cider nod.
See, like an almond joy without the chocolate.
Oh, yeah, but I mean, I don't really get the fucking spoiled milk.
Ugh, that stuff's horrible.
I can still taste it.
I'm like having post-traumatic stress from...
I'm just going to sit here and enjoy this for a second.
Fuck you, Jay.
You don't understand the relief.
Oh, yo, I understand. I've never gotten coconut either, I don't think.
Mm. Tastes pretty good. Not
yeah, lie. I bet. I wouldn't know.
Okay. You can eat anything you want without gaining weight, but yes. Your body will jump to...
You're just like, I don't care about the other one.
But your body will jump to 230 pounds and no amount of working out will lose you any weight.
No.
Well, yeah, hey, it's a...
230's fat, isn't it?
230 is fat for me.
Well, that's what I'm saying. That the question makes no sense.
It's no sense, yeah. It's
saying you'll never gain any more weight than 230.
No.
Well, I weigh over that, so I'll fucking take it.
Yeah, I don't, so, like, not even
yeah,
close.
Yeah, I don't, no.
No.
No. No.
All right. I'm spinning again.
230's a lot.
Caramel corn or moldy cheese? All right, that's a...
Or basement. That's what they should fucking name it.
Basement. It's mothballs.
Which one did we say
basement.
Was the moldy cheese?
I have no
cheese?
Idea.
I think it's this one.
Yeah, okay. I'm surprised we haven't ran out yet.
We have plenty in here.
Yeah, I know, but that's for the little thing. Did you get basement?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, does it taste like fucking basement?
No, nothing this isn't my first cheese. Rodeo with this one.
That is not cheese.
Yeah.
Yeah, this ain't my first rodeo with that one, but after getting spoiled milk so many times,
yeah.
Nah, I'm not even
spoiled
phased.
Milk's fucking
really?
Horrible.
Really? Because that one gagged me.
Sorry, Jason, again.
You don't understand. I've been hit with that fucking spoiled milk one like five different
yeah,
times.
Yeah, I've never gotten coconut every time I've tried that. Nope. Nope. Nope, 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 nope. What's the next one?
Lame. Hang on.
Lame. There's a lot of lame ones on there, isn't there?
Yeah, it's just kids come up with these sometimes.
You damn whippersnappers.
It's like questions about Pokemon and shit.
Oh, do a Pokemon one.
No. This one's for Casey just because I want to hear him rant.
Okay, cool.
You end feminism, but you...
End feminism.
And I want to hear Ashley's response to it. You end feminism, but you become an oppressed woman.
Well, the thing is all women to feminism feel like they're oppressed. So
I think they mean legitimately oppressed, like you don't get rights. Like I'm thinking you lose the vote and shit like that.
So wait, you have a choice to end feminism or...
If you end feminism, you alone are the only oppressed woman.
Wait, so I don't get it.
You become an oppressed woman.
Yes, you take away feminism, there's no more like...
And you don't have to deal with it or hear about
there's,
it.
There's no more people
nothing.
Like Lacey Green out there.
But you become the oppressed woman.
Yes.
I don't fucking... Women aren't impressed, I don't think.
Like, I just... I'm pressing the button because at least I can still get free drinks at the bar.
Hold on a second. Did you just say...
That and here we go. The bait has been taken.
Did you just say that women are not oppressed in any way?
I said I don't think that a lot of them are that they're saying that they are. Like, it's all woe is me.
Where's my popcorn? Oh, no, don't let off the hook easy.
A lot of it is woe is me, I feel. Really? Like that one girl said, there's so many women that are jealous and hateful towards each other. Mm-hmm. If feminism's going to do anything, that has to stop
it
first.
It does have to stop.
It's fun to watch him flounder.
No, I'm serious.
Women will never get along like that.
And it's, I know, and here's the thing. It's not just feminism. It's everyone in America. I think everyone in America thinks they have it bad, and I don't think they realize how good they have it. It's not just with feminism. It's basically with everything. I'm just saying.
So it's not about women, as you've often decided? It's
oh,
just,
it's always about women. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hey, like I say, man, Adam was fine until that bitch Eve came along.
Well...
He was like riding tigers naked and shit, all like, wee, I'm going to masturbate. And then she came along and was like, here, try this apple.
He was like, wee, I'm going to masturbate? Is that what you just said?
Yeah, and then she came along and she was like, here, try this apple. And then just everything
it's
went to
shit.
It's
because you're a stupid fuck, because men are stupid fucks. That's why.
It's because you have this thing in between your legs
that for some reason, I don't know if it like grabs us by our dick. Like,
yes, by all means, my vagina controls your head.
See, here's the thing. You women know it. You know it.
And that's what... Ashley, how do you feel about all this?
One of the deadliest things in the world is when a woman knows how much a vagina means to a man.
That lady did. That's why she was like, I'll give you a blowjob.
Yeah, I know. Jesus.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yes, we're all aware that the vagina is a pretty powerful thing there. But,
exactly.
I don't really think that there's a whole lot of feminism, per se.
Well, they said that it's like dying out because a lot of people are realizing it's just women that broke up or a guy broke up with them and they're turning to like a hate group. No, I'm serious. I'm serious. That's what they're saying.
It's not like a hate group. Like, this isn't how I looked at it at all.
No, they're saying a lot of women are abandoning it because they feel like it is. It's turning into maybe. One.
Yeah, I don't hate men. I didn't.
You used to.
She hated a man.
I definitely hated a man.
Well, he ruined a lot of shit in your life. I don't blame you.
So do you think Casey's views on women are healthy?
No.
I know they're unhealthy.
Could you elaborate?
I'll admit it. I'll admit that they're unhealthy. No. I'll admit that they're unhealthy. But I don't care because a lot of people make it unhealthy.
What?
In other words, it's not my fault.
No, it is my fault. But here's the thing. I don't make other people suffer for it. I'm not out there, you know, trying to ruin other people's lives because I believe feminism is evil.
We just have a weekly show where you bitch about it.
No one watches us.
But what to you makes feminism evil? I need an example.
Because, like I said, it's not turning into equal rights. It's turning into women wanting to be more powerful than men. Like I said, that one lady wrote a book about how saying they should kill 90% of men and keep 10% around as worker bees. A little fucked up.
So here's the thing. You know where that comes from? I'll tell you. This is my opinion on where that stems from. Because you have...
Birth control. No.
It's because you have women like me who marry people like...
You almost said his name. You're like, that son of a bitch.
Yeah. And then they take complete control. Yeah. Right? So you spend 13 years married to a man who has had complete control of your life, your money, the decisions you make, the places you go, the cars that you own, mm-hmm. the whole nine yards. And then that guy leaves.
Yeah. Like my dad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like that.
And he never came back for the pack of cigarettes. I still think he is.
You know, he just never left the whore's house. So, you know, then I had to learn how to do things on my own.
Yeah.
So in doing so, I learned that I could be powerful and successful. Yeah. And not only that, but I'm more powerful and successful than he is.
I know. And that's the thing.
But there's a great feeling because you've spent our whole lives in society looking at like my grandfather who's completely... He's the head of that household.
Yeah.
My father was the head of the household.
And I have no problem with that.
Blaine was the head.
Yeah.
Damn it, I said his name.
Fuck.
Who cares?
You're like, son of a bitch.
We talked about everybody else's name. What's the difference at this point?
Hey, we're naming
might as well. And Casey damn near drew us a map. So. Yeah,
See, that's what I'm saying. I have no problem with that. But what I have a problem is when I'm seeing it go further than that. I have no problem with an independent woman. But I also see a lot of confusion that for some reason a lot of women think independence is being a cunt. And that's what I have a problem with.
I'm a cunt.
No, you're not.
Really?
No.
Are you sure?
No. You stick up for yourself when the time comes.
I do.
But I see a lot of women out there that are just fucking horrible. Horrible people. And they say that... They get it mixed up with independence. They're like I see a lot of it, like, oh, you just can't handle an independent woman. Independence and being a cunt is two completely different things. I just see a lot of people getting it mixed up.
I think that, like, okay, so I'm super strong, super independent.
Yeah.
I take care of myself.
Yeah.
No one helps me. I don't get child support.
Yeah.
I have full custody of my child.
Yeah.
I don't ask Jason for anything.
Yeah.
Nor would I.
Yeah.
For clarification, Jason is the current boyfriend, not the ex-husband.
Thank you for that.
All copyright reserved.
I'm just trying to be clear here and make sure everybody's following the story.
Yeah, see, I think we're just both getting our things confused because I have no problem with that whatsoever. Yeah. My mom is a very strong, independent woman.
Yeah, we have to be.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying.
I wasn't left with any choice.
That is not what I see feminism as. I see feminism as like this, you know, dyke cut hair and, you know, chewing the back of spitting, armpit fucking braiding, you know, fuck men, you know, because I was hurt by one in fifth grade, so I'm going to take it out on everyone.
That's, now hold on.
That's what I hate.
Now,
getting canceled.
You threw in that last part though with the fuck men because one pissed me off. I mean, sometimes
I know, but that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm trying to say. That is life. A lot of people, I feel bad for younger kids. You know why? Because no one tells them when you were young that you were going to be hurt in life.
I did. I told Abby straight up, there's no such thing as a happy ending. Exactly. There's no such thing as a fairy tale.
Yeah.
There is no Prince Charming.
Yeah. There's the thing. Well, no one.
Damn.
No.
I'd love to have her bedtime story.
I wish someone would told me that. I fucking wish someone told me that. You have these kids raised up. You're like, oh, you're going to go to school. You're going to go to college. You're going to have a family. You're going to have a house. No one tells you it doesn't work like that. And you are going to get butt fucked through life the whole time.
I didn't tell her that part.
Yeah. And here's the thing.
But that's okay because she's going to go hang out with a pedophile in the evening.
Yeah. And when I hear, you know, when
so
I,
she might find out on her own.
Oh my God! Shut up.
You sick fuck.
See, I largely stayed out of that the whole time. But oh, I have one question. Press the button?
No, wait, I forget the question.
Yeah, I forgot about the question too.
I figured you end feminism, but you become an oppressed woman.
No,
I'm pressing the button because at least I can get free drinks at the bar.
Oh.
I don't know.
I don't pay for shit when I go out.
Yeah, see? So you pressing the button?
I don't pay for shit when I go out. What the fuck?
Yeah, and before Jason, I could get laid every time I went out.
Jesus. See? I was talking about that to my friend last night. I was like, a woman can get laid whenever they want. A man have to do a juggling act.
Yeah, I'm pressing the button.
I'm still going with no.
So button to press it. Words. Pressing the button ends feminism.
And you're an oppressed
woman. I'm really not even trying to end feminism. I just like the free drinks.
Yeah, just end feminism. Pressing the button.
Well, Casey, it's you and I spinning.
Fucking piece of shit.
I'll spin.
Fucking hate
strawberry me. Banana smoothie or dead fish?
Oh, that one's bad, too. Ugh.
All right. I think
that's the one I had on Christmas Eve, and I woke up with it still in my mouth. Oh, that's what she said. God damn it.
I don't know if we have that one.
We might have to go into the reserves.
Well,
that one's hard to tell.
Yeah,
it
is.
Because it looks like the popcorn one.
And it kind of looks like the peach one.
Oh, I hope we don't get that fish.
Nah, I'm spinning again. Fuck it. Well, it's easier to tell.
Oh, we got the moldy cheese on the carpet.
God damn it. Why do we never get the fucking blue one? I want to do the blue one. We're doing the blue one.
That's not fair. Because it's just going to taste like toothpaste, which is like...
I just wanted to try the toothpaste one.
It's just going to taste like mint. That is the most obnoxious sound ever.
I know.
My ears.
We're doing it for the radio people.
I got the raspberry.
That does straight up taste like toothpaste.
I got raspberry.
Shocking.
Sorry. It's really good.
That's a little overpowering.
It doesn't taste like feminism.
Oh, man. Sorry. Yeah, that's definitely toothpaste.
All right. So what did you say? Do like two more?
I don't know. Where's our time at?
Yeah, I'd say about two more.
All right.
Let's do two more. If you can find a good one, I know it'd be so.
Oh, my God. This is such a first world question.
First world problem.
Yeah. You get lightning fast internet, always, but you lose three fingers, but they're of your choice.
Lightning fast internet.
Hold on, I'm looking at my fingers. I can lose the pinkies.
You're like, which one do I finger bang myself?
All right, these two got to stay. To double click the mouse and to double click the mouse.
Yeah, exactly. Flick the bean.
To flick the bean. I'm gonna say internet because I could go without my pinkies.
Yeah, I don't. What do you even use those for? Like, I can pick that up fine
what
without
do you
my
need
pinky.
Pinkies for?
Yeah.
You just can't be fancy. Yeah, it's quiet.
Indubitably.
I mean, And then I think I need to keep my thumbs, though.
Yeah, there's, yeah, those are kind of important. Need thumbs.
I'd get rid of my ring fingers.
I don't need this ring finger. Thing. So, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I can get rid of this ring finger.
Yeah, you know what? I'm taking the internet.
Yeah, fuck that.
Ah, dude, we're wrong.
People like their fingers.
Have
people
a, have
are
a
obsessed with the internet, man.
Apparently not as much as we are.
That's surprising, man.
Juicy pear or booger? It's green. The green one.
Is it's it the green fleck green one?
Yeah, it's the fleck one.
With spot.
Oh, man. Oh, just burped up basement.
This one must be... Yeah,
if right. I remember, I'm pretty sure this one tastes like basement, too.
Oh, Christ.
Yep, there's basement.
Pear.
I don't really see how that's booger.
Maybe that's not pear.
I don't understand how that's
boogery.
Nope,
it's pear. It just tastes like I'm eating a candle.
Like a Yankee candle?
Yeah.
I never ate my boogers as a kid. I have no way to judge the...
Either have I. Mm-mm. This one just tastes like basement again.
I got a ginormous booger off my nose ring the other day.
Oh, really?
That's why I don't understand fucking nose piercings, man. You know that shit's got fucking...
It doesn't happen all the time. It's like the first time.
I already get mad fucking boogers clogging up my nose and shit. The last thing I need is to provide a catch
you
for
small nose freaks. How do you think I feel? This Jew nose.
You don't even fucking need to worry about blowing your nose. That shit just walks out.
Yeah, I know. And the funny thing is since I have a coal stove now, I was using coal and my boogers were turning black. So it's like I have to get one of those masks. Funny story, the mask really doesn't work because my nose is so big. There's holes in the mask. Like, the mask doesn't fit around my face tight enough. So there's, I can still smell the coal.
You live in a house where you have to wear a mask.
He's just to fill the coal. Just to fill the hopper. Because coal kicks up a lot of dust when it's dry.
Be like, Casey, that's not acceptable.
I don't know what to say to that, actually.
It's like, and you just spent the last hour here. Good for you.
That'll just be your little secret.
I feel like I needed a
She's
waiver.
Gonna go home a with waiver. fucking smokers lung.
Black lung disease. Kill you. He's gonna watch this show.
He's gonna be so mad.
He's gonna be like, God damn it, Ashley.
Well, you know what? He's gonna have to fucking take a Tuesday off and come and get on the show.
I know, exactly.
What of it?
Because we'd like to get both of you on at the same time.
You know, I work from home now, starting Monday.
I know, that's why I asked you. We got the new microphone in, and me and Jay wanted to try it. I'm like, dude, you came in for Quizzo, and I was like, we'll ask Ashley.
She's working from home now, which means she's going to get fat. Because I know I would. Well, fatter.
Yeah, fatter.
I'm not sure it makes a difference. I sat on my ass for the last 15 years at the other place I worked at.
Yeah, but you have unlimited access to your fridge.
That's true.
Yeah.
I also don't like to buy groceries, though.
Shit, I gotta buy some tonight.
Hence why I'm at the other place so often. Your place of employment.
Moving on. We don't discuss that because boss will not be happy. Who gives a fuck?
So let's do one more, you think?
Yeah, I'm trying to find a good one.
All right. Find something like about hookers or something.
This is one case you'll love.
Great.
You can shoot lasers from your eyes, but you'll have a lazy eye.
No.
Lasers from my eyes.
Give me the laser eyes.
That's what I can say. I have a lazy eye.
Ashley, you're going to do our send off.
How do you not want laser eyes?
Why would you want a lazy eye?
Because I get laser eyes. I mean, it might not always shoot where I want it to, but at least 50% of the target will be taken care of.
Someone makes fun of you, just fucking laser them to death. Like, no one would make fun of you.
And make sure nobody's standing next to you. Yeah.
Chocolate pudding or canned dog food?
Brown one.
Jay, you racist.
I am the furthest.
Do you have black friends? Is that why?
I do not, actually. I don't know any.
Ugh, man. We're going to hell. Already there.
It's pudding.
You fucking lucky bitch.
I already am going to hell because I think you ought to televise Special Olympics boxing.
But I can see it now. Make a good point. Like, are all the parking spots handicapped? Like, where do the normal people park?
They get the special parking up front.
The normal people get the normal parking up front.
Oh man, well, thanks for
goddamn switch for once.
Yeah, exactly. Well, thanks for coming on, Ashley.
Yeah, it was super fun.
Yeah, it was.
You all were... right, everybody. Well, thanks for coming out and hanging out with us. Thanks for meeting our.
Would you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor?
Our neighbor Ashley, and if you like what we do, be sure to like and subscribe to the videos. If you're listening to us on iTunes, Google Play, or one of the podcatchers, be sure to leave us a review, good or bad. They all help. If you want to support the show and help make it all possible, you can contribute as little as a dollar an episode at Patreon.
Dollar make you
holla. What?
Dollar make you holla.
Okay. At patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. You can find us on Twitter at hostileopinions. You can find us on Facebook. You can find us on Google Plus. And anyway, we'll see you next week.
Have a good one.
Bye.
See y'all later.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.